Today we're going to be looking at a rather enigmatic painting by Raphael of a young woman with a unicorn. This was painted in either 1505 or 1506 and was originally oil on panel until its restoration work in 1934, where it was transferred to canvas. In fact, during this conservation work in 1934, a wheel, St Catherine's wheel, a pond, a cloak, and a palm were removed to reveal a unicorn that the woman was holding, which was originally painted by Raphael. Raphael probably originally painted a dog, but then changed it to a unicorn for reasons that we don't know. To this day, there's much speculation about who this woman is. One of the strongest theories is that she's Maddalena Strozzi. Maddalena Strozzi was an Italian woman who married the Italian merchant Agnolo Doni in 1503. Then, in 1506, we know she had a different portrait done. The reason that we believe this woman with the unicorn might be Maddalena Strozzi is that this resembles the 1506 portrait. For example, she's in the same seated position, facing the artist in the same way. She has the same unimpressed, slightly blank expression on her face. She has the same long, thin, straight nose as in the unicorn painting. Both paintings have the same lip size, colour, and shape. She also wears a similar necklace, which is long and hangs low on her neck. It's a red gem with a pearl pendant underneath. Both paintings also show the same blonde, rather wide-set eyebrows. However, the unicorn girl might not be Strozzi, as the later painting in 1506 of Strozzi had darker, duller eyes. Strozzi also appears to have darker hair, and Strozzi certainly has a plumper facial structure. All of these things might have changed in the three interstitial years between the two portraits being painted, although this does seem unlikely. Another suggestion is that this unicorn girl was Laura Orsini. Laura Orsini was the daughter of a renowned Renaissance beauty, Giulia Farnese. Farnese was officially married to Orsino Orsini, however he was often reputed to be unattractive. Giulia was probably the mistress of Pope Alexander VI, and Laura may have been the Pope's child. Laura Orsini was 13 at the time that this portrait was painted, and she was planning a wedding to Niccolò della Rovere. The evidence that Laura is the girl in the painting is as follows. Firstly, the girl in the painting is clearly blonde, and this was a trait shared by a lot of the Pope's illegitimate children. Moreover, the tower in the background of the painting is probably a tower in Urbino, and Urbino was a province ruled by the Rovere family, who Laura was going to marry into. Beyond this, Laura is also wearing Giulia Farnese's necklace, her own mother's necklace, which we can see from lawyer and legal documentation around the era. It's also important to recognise that whilst the unicorn does symbolise virginity and purity, it was also part of the Farnese crest, so this might be another indication that the girl is Laura Orsini. The unicorn was a symbol of chastity for a soon-to-be-wed woman, as mythology dictates that the unicorn can only be caught by a virgin maiden. Therefore, the portrait was intended to advertise this young woman's marriageability, her physical beauty, her virginity, and her pious fatuity. Since antiquity, and then again in medieval bestiaries, the unicorn was a symbol of purity and chastity. This was because only a virgin maiden could tame the unicorn, who would then fall asleep in her lap. Many scholars drew allegory from this fable, suggesting that the Virgin Mary was the young maiden and that the unicorn was Christ. European folklore suggested that they were as small as a goat and weak when they were babies, known as kids. In the Renaissance period, the unicorn developed a more secular meaning as a direct symbol of feminine purity. Marco Polo wrote about the unicorn as if he had seen a real animal when he returned to Venice. What he actually saw was probably a herd of rhinos. He said, "Scarcely smaller than elephants, they have the hair of a buffalo and feet like an elephant's. They have a single, large black horn in the middle of the forehead. They have a head like a wild boar's. They spend their time by preference wallowing in mud and slime. They are very ugly brutes to look at. They are not at all such as we describe them when we relate that they let themselves be captured by virgins, but clean contrary to our notions. In this painting, the dog, which was originally painted by Raphael, is also a marital symbol of fidelity. However, the unicorn is much more apt in conveying specifically virginal qualities of a much younger woman.